This event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. On my left in the blue corner at 235 pounds, from Tampa, Florida, Frankie Lane. As we are waiting for Kamala, the Ugandan warrior.
Bill, I'll tell you this. I don't know. I don't think Skandar Akbar is going to bring Kamala down here with Hacksaw Duggan standing in the ring with that two before.
I don't either, Jim.
They're looking around. This match is scheduled. Kamala and Frankie Lane. Akbar's no way. He's a smart man. He's not going to bring Kamala down here with Duggan in the ring of that two before. Ladies and gentlemen, while we're trying to find out exactly what's going on here, recently in the Superdome, what a tremendous wrestling event. Thousands of people, over 20,000 on hand. What a matchup. Jake the Snake Roberts against the Snowman. Muhammad Ali was there. Bill Watts describes the action.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cowboy Bill Watts here from the floor of the Superdome, and it's pandemonium as you see the man, Muhammad Ali, making a triumphant return for the first time since September of 1978, when he set history to become the only man to regain the world's heavyweight boxing title for the third time, and he defeated Leon Sphinx. And there you see the Barbarian and Jake the Snake waiting in the ring, because Ali's here for a reason. The Snowman is defending the Mid-South television title against Jake the Snake. And Bundini Brown, Muhammad Ali's spiritual advisor, is signed as the Snowman's manager, and Ali came to be with him in this first appearance in the Superdome of the Snowman. There you see Ernie Ladd, a big fan of Muhammad Ali, restraining him as he goes, and Jake the Snake taunting him. There you see Bundini Brown in the white shirt. There's Bundini, there's the Snowman. The fabulous Snowman, the muscular, tremendously iron hard wrestler that came and taken Mid-South by storm, and is now the television champion. Seems styling, looking fine in that hat. Jake the Snake in the ring, taunting Muhammad Ali. There's Boyd Pierce, there's the Barbarian. Bundini Brown, a few last words, cautioning the Snowman. Ernie Ladd there on the scene. Carl Fergie, 20,000 screaming, exuberant fans at the Superdome in New Orleans, June 1st. Bundini Brown, the man who devised the slogan, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. The man who took Ali to the mountain, the mystery of it all. And Muhammad Ali, sparks still fly from the champion's eye. There you see Jake the Snake. And you can tell the Snowman has been working out with Bundini Brown and Muhammad Ali. They'll never again doubt when he says that somebody's a friend of his, or that somebody will show up for him, because he's proved beyond a shadow of doubt. And New Orleans turned out the red carpet for Muhammad Ali. There you see the Barbarian, collar and elbow, Jake the Snake, Carl Fergie on the scene. Top wrist lock. The Snowman, so powerful, a 600-pound squat, 500-pound bench press, tremendously powerful individual. He is so strong, so confident, he can lay back and let you take your best shot and still come out. At any moment, he can pull the gun on you and hit you with that powerful power slam. You see him stun Jake the Snake, and he gives you the Ali shuffle. There's Bundini Brown, the man who has been in the corner of more important matches. He was Ali's advisor for 20 years. And Ali, there's a favor to Bundini Brown and the Snowman. There you see why the Snowman is so powerful, just like getting hit with a Mack truck. The Weasel Maker, or the Barbarian, very upset about the trend of events out there, as again Jake the Snake hits that immovable object and slithers out of the ring. Snowman confidently waiting in the ring, stalking Jake the Snake. Snake over there taunting Ali. The whole crowd chanting Ali, Ali, Ali. Pandemonium. You can see the tremendously powerful trapezes. There you see Ali, the spark flying. Nothing turns a champ on like the crowd. The trip. The Barbarian tripped the Snowman from behind. Snowman fell heavily to his face. Ali is after the Barbarian. Bundini Brown's after Ali. It's pandemonium here, but now watch closely. Jake the Snake. Looks like he's going for the, he went for the DDT. Jake the Snake hit the Snowman with the DDT. No man has ever come out of the DDT. Ali is after the Barbarian. Jake the Snake, the Snowman kicked out. He powered out of the DDT. No man has ever done that. Showing what tremendous strength. He's stunned. He's going on courage. And look at how upset the Barbarian is. Jake the Snake quickly drops a leg on the Snowman. Wanted to keep him down. Guy goes again for the fall. So confident is Jake the Snake. Look at the power. Here is the Snowman. Threw Jake the Snake clear out of the ring on the floor. The Barbarian coming into the ring, hooking up to Full Nelson. The Snowman in the Full Nelson. Carl Fergie getting ready to signify a disqualification. And I think Carl Fergie just decided to let him handle it. Now Jake the Snake over. He's hit Bundini. Ali warned him if he touched Bundini, he'd get involved. Ali said he'd get involved if he bothered Bundini. The Snowman has broke the Full Nelson. Jake the Snake is again picking on Bundini. You see the champion, his jacket off. And watch that right on the button. Right above the button, so quick. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee, and Jake the Snake found out why Ali was the three-time world's champion. And the Barbarian, Bundini Brown exhorting him on, the Snowman popping him from the other side. There, the power slam. The Snowman takes the measure of Jake the Snake. 1, 2, 3. The Snowman still the television champion. And listen to the crowd at this Superdome. It's pandemonium, and the Snowman does the Ali shuffle. He's on fire. The crowd has been electrified. The winner, the Snowman, Bundini Brown, and Muhammad Ali, as Jake the Snake goes down to defeat.
Well, the Snowman certainly walked tall in the Superdome. Hank he Barr does go, Muhammad
to come
Ali.
Down to the ring as long as Hacksaw Duggan is here.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you hear that conversation in the ring. Hacksaw Duggan says he's not leaving, and obviously Kamal and General Akbar have refused to appear because of that board. As I was saying, the Snowman did some serious walking tall. He does know Muhammad Ali and Bundini Brown. That's quite obvious what an athlete he is, and we'll be back with more exciting Mid-South Wrestling after this important wrestling announcement.